Colossians.
Kitabu cha Wakolosai.
Chapter what? Was it chapter 2? Verse number 15. No, 13, 14 and 15. Colossians.
Wakolosai mlango wa pili.
Chapter 2. Verse number 13.
13.
The Bible says, and you who are dead in your trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, God made alive together with him, having forgiven us all our trespasses, 14, by canceling, you see, you have keywords, you can see them already, by canceling the record of debt that stood against us with its legal demands. Paul Musimi can explain this better. Legal demands. This he set aside, nailing it to the cross. Number 15, he disarmed the rulers and authorities and put them to open shame by triumphing over them in him. Father, we thank you today.
Baba, tukushukuru leo.
Thank you for the gift of life.
Asante kwa karama ya maisha.
Thank you for the opportunity to stand before the saints.
Na fursa ya kusimama mbele ya watakatifu.
Speak to us in a special way.
Nena nasi kwa njia speciali.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Kwa jina la Yesu tuwaomba.
Amen.
Amen.
Have your seat. God bless you.
Mkae Mungu awabariki.
So put number 13 there.
13.
We want to study this. This we are always talking about the doctrine of redemption.
Kila mara tumekuwa tukinena juu ya itikadi za ukombozi.
You see, God spoke to me.
Mungu alinena nami.
That today the church is going through a very difficult situation.
Ya kuwa leo kanisa inapitia hali ngumu sana.
Because people are not taught the gospel.
Kwa maana watu hawafunzwi injili.
So the church has been commercialized.
Kwa hiyo kanisa imefanyika kuwa biashara.
That's why the gospel, the scripture is not taught in churches.
Ndiposa maandiko hayafunzwi kanisani.
I want to give you an example.
Nataka niwape mfano.
Now, you have a true pastor.
Sasa unaye mchungaji wa kweli.
Called by God.
Aliyeitwa na Mungu.
And here you have a fake one.
Na hapa unaye gushi.
Who is out there to do businesses.
Ambaye yako pale kufanya biashara.
Now, this fake pastor.
Sasa huu mchungaji
will try his best.
Atajaribu sana.
To make sure that he attracts as many people as he can.
Kuhakikisha amewavutia wengi kadri ya uwezo wake.
Because when many people comes.
Kwa maana wengi wanapokuja.
He's going to get more offering.
Ataenda kupata sadaka kwa wingi.
He's going to get money.
Na yeye atapata hela.
And everybody want offering.
Na kila mtu anataka sadaka.
Can we say hallelujah?
Tuseme hallelujah.
Now, this true pastor.
Sasa huu mchungaji wa kweli.
Because he preached the gospel.
Kwa maana anahubiri injili.
People may feel it's not so attractive.
Watu watahisi ya kuwa havutii sana.
But the thief.
Lakini yule mwizi.
Will try to use the language.
Atajaribu kutumia lugha.
That is attractive.
Ambayo ni ya kuvutia.
So many people will go there.
Kwa hiyo wengi wataenda pale.
Let me give you an example.
Wacha niwape mfano.
Here you have God.
Hapa unaye Mungu.
And here you have the devil.
Na hapa shetani.
God says,
Mungu anasema,
I've given you everything in this garden.
Nimekupa vyote katika bustani hii.
You may eat.
Waweza kula.
But this fruit, this one.
Lakini hili tunda hili.
Don't eat.
Usile.
Because the day you eat, you're going to die.
Kwa maana utakapoila utakufa.
And then here you have the devil.
Na kisha hapa unaye shetani.
He says, did God say you don't eat this one?
Anasema je Mungu alisema usile hii.
He knows. He got.
Anajua.
Knows.
Anajua.
That the day you eat this one.
Kwa siku utakapokula hii.
Your eyes are going to open.
Macho yako yatafunguka.
You are going to know things.
Utajua mambo.
You are going to become like him.
Utakuwa kama yeye.
Knowing everything good and bad.
Vyote vima na vibaya.
That's why he's hiding good things from you.
Ndiposa amewafichia mema.
So you see people, Adam and Eve, they believed the devil.
Kwa hiyo Adam na Hawa akamwamini shetani.
Even though he was lying.
Ingawa alikuwa akidanganya.
That's what's happening.
Haya ndio matukio.
The devil used attractive words.
Shetani akatumia maneno ya kuvutia.
And they obeyed him.
Nao wakamtii.
They ate the fruit.
Wakala tunda.
After eating, what's happening?
Baada ya kula nini kilichotokea?
Genesis chapter 3 verse 1.
Mwanzo 3 mlango wa kwanza.
Tunaenda haraka sana. Genesis chapter 3 verse 1. Look at this.
Tizama haya.
Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said unto the woman, yeah, has God said, ye shall not eat of every tree in the garden. Can you put ESV wherever? Look at that. And the woman said to the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden. Tatu. But God said, you shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the midst of the garden, neither shall you touch it, lest you die. Now look at this. But the serpent said to the woman, you will not surely die. And this is what people want to hear. For God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will do what? Will be opened, and you will be like God. He didn't mention some words there.
Hakutaja maneno fulani pale.
He didn't say you shall know good end.
Hakusema utajua mema na mabaya. He didn't say that.
Are you here? Look what he said. Hallelujah. For God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened and you will be like. But there is to know good and what? And evil, which he didn't reveal. So he's using a different word. He's playing with words.
Anatumia maneno tofauti.
And you will be like him.
Nawe utakuwa kama
now look at this. So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was to be desired to make one wise, she took of its fruit and what? And ate. And she also gave some to her husband, who was with her, and he did what? He also ate. Now what's happening? Look at this. Then the eyes of both were the way the devil said. You know, in whatever he said, you have some truth and some what?
Lies.
And some lies, but skillful lies. Now, their eyes were opened, and then they knew that they were what? But he didn't tell them that. He didn't say you will know you are naked. He didn't say you are going to know good and evil. He didn't mention that one. Now, after that, and they sewed fig leaves together and made themselves what? Clothes. Now, what's happening? Number 8. Look at this. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of day. What happened? And the man and his wife hid themselves. Mungu wa milele. God was their friend, isn't it?
Mungu alikuwa rafiki yao.
Their creator.
Muumbaji wao.
Now they are running away from
sasa
him.
Sasa wanamtoroka.
From the presence of the Lord, God among the trees of the garden. They are now hiding. They don't want to see God. Now look at this. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, where are you? And he said, I heard the sound of you in the garden. And I was afraid. You see? So the eyes opened. And because the eyes opened, it now brought what? Shame. It brought what? Fear. Man is now hiding. Look, because I was naked, now man can know he is naked. He can be ashamed that he is naked. And I hid myself. Look at this. He said, who told you that you are naked? Who told you that you are? Here is where we are standing. I told you last Sunday that the backbone of the ministry of the devil is guilt. He makes sure that he can create a situation whereby you feel guilt in your life. In my life, if you want me to hate you, make me feel guilt. I will hate you. You'll never be my friend. No matter who you are. Don't put me in a corner. Where you want me to feel bad. Where you want me to feel like rejected. Where you want me to feel like, abandoned by God. You cannot be my friend. Not in this life. Not in the life to come. Why should you want me to feel guilt? When you feel guilt, you are ashamed. You start hiding. You lose your confidence. You lose your hope. When somebody is guilty, he goes into hiding.
Anaenda mafichoni.
And the devil wants you to feel guilty. That's the point. He wants you to feel guilt.
Anataka uwe na hatia.
He wants you to feel unwanted.
Anataka uhisi
ya he wants you to feel you are a bad person.
Na wewe ni mtu mbaya.
He wants you to feel God has rejected you. He wants you to feel that God cannot hear from you. You are evil.
Kusikia, wewe ni muovu.
That's what the devil wants.
Ndivyo shetani
anataka. Because he operates through guilt.
Kwa maana anafutenda kazi kupitia hatia.
He operates through condemnation.
Na hali ya hukumu.
Now let me ask you.
Wacha nikuulize.
When their eyes opened.
Wakati macho yao yalifunguka.
Where was the serpent?
Naye nyoka.
Where was the devil?
Shetani alikuwa wapi?
He told them, take it. You shall be like God. And then they eat. The eyes opened.
Macho yakafunguka.
Where is he? We don't see him anymore.
Hatumuoni popote.
He just provoked these people.
Yeah,
excite them. Push them, take the fruit, they take, they eat, it disappears. We don't see him. Maybe somewhere there, standing and laughing at these people. He said, now you are finished. You have become my disciples. You are under my feet. I will rule over you. Look at you. And these people are busy looking for majani,
wakitafuta majani ya kujificha,
to cover their nakedness.
Ili wafiche uchi wao.
They are now hiding.
Sasa wajificha.
Even when God came,
hata Mungu alipokuja,
the devil is somewhere.
Shetani yako
watching,
mahali akitizama.
What's happening?
Matukio.
If you cannot feel guilt,
kama hauwezi hisi,
the devil cannot rule over you.
Shetani hauwezi kutawala.
Because when guilt comes,
kwa maana hatia ijapo,
it comes with condemnation.
Huwa yaja na hukumu.
It comes with judgment.
Yaja na hali ya kukumika.
So guilt comes.
Kwa hivyo hatia yaja.
Condemnation comes.
Na kisha hukumu.
Judgment comes.
Na kisha kustumia.
You yourself, you feel that you are zero.
Nawe waisi ya kuwa
you are lost.
Umepotea.
You have sinned.
Umetenda dhambi.
God is against you.
Mungu yuko kinyume.
Heaven is against you.
Kila kitu.
The devil is against you.
Shetani yuko
dhidi yako. Demons are against you.
Mapepo
yuko. Witches are against you.
Hata wachawi.
Everybody is against
you. Kila mtu yuko dhidi yako.
You now go into hiding.
Sasa waenda mafichoni.
You are now abandoned.
Sasa wewe
you start wandering here and there.
Unaanza kutapakaa hapa.
Now listen the scripture.
Sikia maandiko.
Go back to Colossians chapter 2 verse number 13.
Wakolosai 2:13.
Put it there.
Weka pale.
I want you to see what's happening here.
Nataka uone matukio hapa.
Colossians 2:13. Now look at what's happening. And you are dead in your trespasses. It means we were all sinners, and in our sins, we were automatically dead even while living in the flesh. But before God, you're already dead.
Tulikufa ndani ya dhambi zetu mbele ya Mungu.
Now, when the Bible talks about uncircumcision of the flesh, the Bible is talking about the covenant. Because circumcision was an act of God entering into a covenant with Abraham.
Tohara ilikuwa ishara ya Mungu kuingia katika makubaliano na Abraham.
It's like today when people, when you are baptized, automatically it's a covenant with God, with Jesus Christ.
Unapo batizo umeingia katika mkataba na Mungu,
you become a child of God.
Unakuwa mwana wa Mungu.
So in those days,
kwa hiyo siku zile,
it was an act of a covenant.
Kupashwa tohara ilikuwa
between God and Abraham.
Kati ya Mungu na Abraham.
Now, God made a life together with him, having forgotten all our trespasses.
Mungu akafanya uhai naye hali ya kusahau dhambi zetu.
Now here, Jesus Christ died for us.
Yesu akatukufia.
Took away our sins.
Akachukua dhambi zetu.
And now he made us alive again.
Akatufanya hai tena.
He gave us a new life.
Akatupatia maisha
through Jesus Christ.
Kupitia Yesu Kristo.
Now look verse number 14.
14.
Look what's happening here. By canceling. To cancel is to destroy.
Kwa kuangamiza.
Is to remove.
Kutoa.
Is to nullify.
Na kuiweka bure.
So whatever record and debt that stood against us.
Deni zilizokuwa juu yetu.
Now, the Bible says he canceled the record, which means the devil was having like a notebook whereby he is writing everything that you do. He writes it down.
Biblia inasema has a record. Ondoa nakala zote zilizokuwa zimenakiliwa.
You do ABCD, write down.
Ukitenda anaandika.
You speak like that, write it down.
Ukinena hivi anaandika.
You depose an act, write it down.
Anaandika.
And then it is a record book.
Kisha anao nakili ambayo amehifadhi kitabu.
That book.
Kitabu kile.
We even read in the scripture.
Tukasoma kwenye maandiko.
In Revelation.
Katika ufunuo.
That books were opened.
Ya kuwa vitabu vilifunguliwa.
Kweli ama hapana?
Kweli.
And in those books,
na katika vitabu vile,
there are things written.
Kunayo mambo yaliyoandikwa.
And people will be judged
na watu watahukumiwa
according to what is written
kulingana na
yaliyoandikwa in those books.
Katika vitabu vile.
Now people who will be judged
sasa watu watahukumiwa
according to those books
kulingana na vitabu vile,
are people who have not accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Because when you accept Jesus as Lord and Savior, your record is cancelled. It is destroyed. It is nullified. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's what the Bible says. Bible says Jesus Christ, through his death, he canceled the record of death that stood against us. Who are us? Us are the people who have accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Now, the Bible says, the legal demands.
Katika hali za kisheria.
When you hear legal demands,
unaposikia hali zinazoletwa sheria.
Brother Musimi can even expand more.
Ndugu Musimi anaweza fafanua zaidi.
So that you can understand.
Ili uelewe.
Legal demand here entails the requirements.
Inahitaji maadili fulani.
It entails the requirement. It means it is the they are the requirements.
Inamaanisha unahitajika.
God's requirement, for example.
Mahitaji ya Mungu kwa mfano.
Concerning our conduct.
Kulingana na hali zetu.
Concerning our relationship with Him.
Na hali ya uhusiano yetu.
So those requirements.
Kwa hiyo mahitaji haya.
They were legal.
Yalikuwa ya kisheria.
That's why people who go against them are condemned, are judged. So Jesus says through the scripture that those legal demands, he set them aside by kneeling them at the cross. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Whatever that stood against you were knelt at the cross to give you freedom. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So he cancel your debt.
Kwa hiyo akafuta
and then he give you freedom.
Na kisha akakupa uhuru.
You see, when you lack this understanding,
unaona unapokosa ufahamu huu,
you walk like a prisoner.
Unatembea kama mfungwa.
You walk carrying heavy loads,
unatembea
burdens.
Ukibeba mizigo mizito.
Because the devil would like you to always understand that you are a slave to sins.
Kwa maana shetani anataka uelewe kuwa wewe ni mtumwa wa dhambi kila
mara. He wants always you to understand that God cannot hear, cannot listen from you people.
Na anataka uelewe kuwa Mungu hawezi kusikiza wewe.
The devil wants, whenever you sit down, you look at yourself, look into your conscience, look into your life, you see that you are unworthy, you don't deserve God. That's what the devil wants you to see.
Shetani anataka unapokaa ukiangalia dhamiri yako uone haustahili mbele zake Mungu.
And the devil will excite you, push you, excitate you, send you to do something which is against God.
Na kila mara atakusisimua ili uende kutenda mambo yaliyo kinyume na Mungu.
When you do what is against God,
ukitenda kinyume na Mungu,
you feel guilty.
Unahisi shtu.
He rules.
Anatawala.
That's how he rules.
Hivyo ndivyo anatawala.
When you know the truth, the devil cannot rule over you.
Ukijua ukweli, shetani hawezi kutawala.
He rules upon people who are ignorant.
Anatawala juu ya walio wapuzi.
People who do not know the truth.
Watu wasiojua ukweli.
So he rules them out of ignorance.
Kwa hiyo anawatawala kupitia upuzi wao.
Jesus says,
Yesu anasema,
John chapter 8 verse number 32, you shall know the truth and the truth shall set you free.
Utajua ukweli na utakuweka huru.
If you know this truth,
ukijua ukweli huu,
you are free.
Uko huru.
Let me give you an example.
Wacha nikupe mfano.
First Chronicles chapter 21 verse 1. First Chronicles, there it is, look. Then Satan stood against Israel. What did he do?
Alifanya nini?
He incited David.
Yeye akamsusi Daudi.
To do the census.
Ili akafanye hesabu ya
to wali. Number the Israelites.
Afanye hesabu ya
which was against God.
Ambao ilikuwa kinyume na Mungu.
Verse number 2. Look at this. So David said to Joab and the commanders of the army, go number Israel from Beersheba to Dan and bring me a report that I may know their number. But Joab said, may the Lord God add to his people 100 times as many as they are. Are they not my Lord, the king, all of them my Lord's servants? Why then should my Lord require this? Why should it be a cause of guilt? Say guilt. Do you see that? Guilt for Israel. Now, look at number four. But the king's word prevailed against Joab. So Joab departed and went throughout all Israel and came back to Jerusalem. Number five. And Joab gave the sum of the numbering of the people to David, and in all Israel there were 1,100,000 men who drew the sword, and in Judah you have 470,000 who drew the sword. It means men who are already at the age of going to war. Now, number six. Look at this. But he did not include Levi or the Levites and Benjamin in the numbering, for the king's command was a taboo. It was bad. It was evil. Number seven. Look at this. But God was displeased with the thing, with this thing, and he struck Israel. Listen to number eight. And David said to God, I have sinned greatly in that I have done. Now look at here. Who told David that you have sinned? Because until now, God has not spoken. God has not spoken. Now. And then David said, but now please take away the iniquity of your servant, for I have acted very foolishly. Now look at number nine. And the Lord spoke to God. Now God speaking out to the prophet. And say, verse number 10, go and say to David, thus says the Lord, three things I offer you. Choose one of them that I may do it to you. Nataka kukupika. Natuma mambo tatu. Chagua moja na nitakuchapa. Now look at this one. So God came to David and said to him, thus says the Lord, choose what you want and God will give it to you. Either 3 years of famine, you only one. 3 months of devastation by your foes. It means you run before your enemies who pursues you. That's what God says there. Or else 3 days of the sword of the Lord. So God himself take charge. Pestilence on the land, with the angel of the Lord destroying throughout all the territory of Israel. Now decide what answer I shall return to him who sent me. So David, give me an answer. Bwana sifiwe. Look at me. You see, when you look at these things, before the prophet came, David started already repenting. What is happening here? David wants the census. Joab, the general, tells David, we cannot do the census. It is evil. It is against the law of God. God wants his people to multiply. He doesn't want the numbering of his own people. It is against the law. The Bible says, David persisted. Go and do what I want. David didn't know that the devil was the one pushing him to do so. You know it is the devil pushing him today because you have read it. It has already been revealed. But in that day, it was not revealed. David didn't know it was the devil was pushing him. So the devil will always push people to sin against God, to do things against God. So he pushes you. You don't know it is him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Give us a First Samuel chapter 24, verse 1. 2 Samuel 24:1. Look at this. Look at this. When Saul returned from following the Philistines, he was told, behold, David is in the wilderness of Engedi. Verse number 2. Then Saul took 3,000 chosen men out of all Israel and went to seek David and his men in front of the wild goats rocks. Look. And he came to the sheepfold by the way, where there was a cave, and Saul went in to relieve himself. Now, David and his men were sitting in the innermost part of Zambena Mikali Kalinamoto. He is looking for David.
Anamtafuta Daudi.
He entered in that cave.
Anaingia pangoni.
To relieve himself.
Ili ajisaidie.
And inside that rock cave, David is there inside.
Daudi yako ndani.
They can see him.
Wanaweza kumuona.
He cannot see them.
Hawezi waona yeye.
Now listen to this.
Sasa sikia haya.
Number four. And the men of David said to him, here is the day of which the Lord said to you, behold, I will give your enemy into your what? Into your hands. And you shall do to him as it shall seem good to you. Now, these are people, they are exciting, pushing David to do something that is against God, just the way we saw that the devil came pushing David to do something that was against the will of God.
Hawa ni watu wanaomsukuma Daudi atende kinyume na Mungu vile tuliona shetani akimsukuma atende kinyume na Mungu.
Sometimes we have friends.
Wakati mwingine tuna
we have people surrounding us.
Kuna walio tuzingira.
And some of these people will speak words to us.
Watanena maneno.
Their words may be sweet in our ears.
Matamu masikioni mwetu.
But we have always to control.
Lakini lazima tujidhibiti.
If these words
kama maneno haya
are coming from God,
yanatoka kwa Mungu,
or from men,
au kwa wanadamu.
Do you understand?
Unaelewa?
Every word that is full of hate cannot come from God.
Kila neno lililo na chuki haliwezi toka kwa Mungu.
But every word that is full of love, that will come from God.
Lakini maneno yote yaliyojaa upendo yanatoka kwa Mungu.
They said,
wakasema,
this is the day now that God has released your enemy into your hands.
Mungu amemwachilia adui wako mkononi mwako.
What are you going to say if it is why it
was? Utasema nini kama ni wewe?
If it were you.
Kama ingelikuwa wewe.
You are going to say, hey, these are my men.
Utasema hao ni watu wangu.
They love me.
Wananipenda.
They want to destroy my enemy.
Wanataka kumwangamiza adui yangu.
So that's what is happening always.
Hiyo ndio matukio kila mara.
This is the day.
Hii ndio siku.
God has given you.
Mungu amekupa.
Your enemies in your hands.
Adui yako mikononi.
Do the way you like.
Wewe tenda unavyopenda.
Now what is happening?
Sasa ni nini kinachotokea?
Then David arose and stealthily cut off a corner of Saul's robe. He cut off, took a knife. You know, these are fighters. He has an epe or a sword, isn't it? So he cut
kwa hiyo akakata
a piece of Saul's robe.
Kipande chake nguo ya vazi la Saul.
Excited, pushed by his friends.
Akiwa amesukumwa na marafiki zake.
Afterwards,
na baadaye,
David had
Daudi
struck him.
Roho wake ukam.
Do you see that? His heart.
Roho wake.
Struck him.
Na ukamgonga.
Or struck him.
Au ulimpiga.
Why is he stroken by his heart?
Mbona anagongwa na moyo wake?
Why is his heart beating?
Mbona moyo wake unamgonga?
This man is his enemy.
Huyu jamani adui yake.
And he has people pushing him.
Na ana watu wanaomsukuma.
Finish this man today.
Angamize huyu mtu leo.
If you don't want to do it,
kama hutaki kutenda,
allow us to do it.
Turuhusu tutende.
He cut the rope.
Akakata vazi lake.
His heart.
Moyo wake.
God didn't come.
Mungu hakuja.
God didn't come.
Mungu hakuja.
They don't talk about God here.
Na nini juu ya
they
Mungu
talk
hako
about the heart of David.
Wananena juu ya moyo wa
being striken.
Ikigonga.
Whenever you commit a sin,
wakati unapotenda dhambi,
an abominable act,
au jambo ambalo
you are going to feel guilt.
Wewe utahisi
your shu heart is going to beat.
Na moyo wako utagonga.
The Holy Spirit will speak to you.
Roho Mtakatifu
you have sinned against God.
Unatenda dhambi kinyume na
even
Mungu.
The devil himself will speak to you.
Atanena nawe.
You have sinned against God.
Dhambi kinyume
na
Mungu.
And that is what he wants.
Na hivyo ndivyo anataka.
You to feel that you have sinned.
Uhisi umetenda dhambi.
So his heart is strong.
Kwa hiyo moyo wake ukagonga.
Why?
Kwa nini?
Because he had cut off a corner of Saul's robe.
Kwa maana alikuwa amekata sehemu ya
vazi. You don't touch somebody anointed.
Usiguse aliyepakwa mafuta.
No matter what.
Haijalishi nini.
Don't touch somebody anointed.
Usimguse aliyepakwa mafuta.
No matter what.
Haijalishi.
I repeat again.
Ninarudia.
We have ujinga in church today.
Tuko na ujinga kanisani leo.
People don't understand things.
Watu hawaelewi haya.
Because they are not taught.
Kwa maana hawafunzwi.
If somebody is anointed.
Kama mtu amepakwa mafuta.
And the person wrongs you.
Na jamaa amekukosea.
Leave the person in God's hands.
Jamaa huyo muache kwa mikono ya
Mungu. Don't take judgment in your hands.
Wewe usichukue hukumu mikononi.
Because the person is anointed.
Kwa maana jamaa ni mpakwa mafuta.
Anointing doesn't die.
Upako haufi.
Anointing lives forever. forever. No matter what the person does, he will still be anointed. The Bible says, Elisha was dead and was buried. After 1 year, he's already dead. Somebody died in the village and he was taken to the burial place to go and to the cemetery. As they were carrying the dead person, they saw enemies, invaders entering the village. So people carrying the dead man had to run away for their lives. They threw away the corpse they were carrying. The Bible says the corpse went and fell in a place where Elisha was buried a year ago. The corpse touched the bones of Elisha. The remains. The Bible says the dead corpse resurrected. Anointing doesn't die. Anointing remains. It is there. Here, Saul is rejected by God. Is possessed by an evil spirit. Still anointed. Verse number 6. Look at this. I didn't write the Bible. He said to his men, the Lord forbid that I should do this thing to my Lord, the Lord's anointed. The Lord anointed. Even though we can say he was rejected.
Oh,
an evil spirit came upon him. Because this guy, whenever the evil spirit came upon him, he is going to remove clothes. He walked naked in the house. Break stuff in the house. Even take a spear. Try to kill David. Several times. David will run away. Take a guitar. He starts singing. God, remember your servant. Remember your anointed. Merciful God. Powerful God. The sin forgiver. It is you, God. Forgive this man. As David is singing, the Bible says, Saul will now feel good. Start breathing normally. You don't touch somebody anointed. Are you here? That's what the Bible says. God forbid that I should touch the anointed man of God. God forbid. Listen to that. The Lord's anointed to put out my hands against him. Seeing he is the Lord's anointed. How many times is he repeating anointed? Do you see that? Now, verse number 7. So David, 7. So David persuaded his men with these words and did not permit them to attack Saul. And Saul rose up and left the cave and went on his way. Look at me. Listen here. The main point is this one. David felt his heart struck, beat him. What are you doing? Now he felt guilt for having cut a piece of the clothes, the robe that the anointed man was wearing. And he said, God forbid. God help me. I cannot touch this man. Now,
sasa,
it means he repented. It means he came back to his mind. But the devil doesn't want you to come back to your mind. He doesn't want you to know that there is a way out. He wants you to remain guilty. To remain under judgment. To remain under condemnation. Because it is when you are guilty, when you feel guilty, that the devil rules. He cannot rule a free mind.
Hawezi tawala akili iliyo wazi.
The devil cannot rule a mind that has been freed. A mind that is living in liberty. No, no.
Hapana.
It is guilt that enables him to rule over us. Colossians chapter 2, verse number 15. Look at what is here.
Tizama hapa.
Read this now.
Soma hii.
He disarmed. So, point number one, he forgave us. He cancelled
yeye anafuta
all the legal wherever sheria, that was standing against us.
Sheria zote zilizosimama dhidi yetu.
He didn't just stop there.
Yeye hakusalia tu.
He went as far as
akaenda hatua
to disarm our enemy.
Ya kumnyang'anya silaha.
To disarm the devil.
Kumnyang'anya silaha.
So that he cannot harm you.
Ili asiweze kukudhuru.
Listen, people.
Sikiza watu.
You know, when you are in a situation,
unapokuwa katika hali fulani,
the first mind that will come to you,
akili ya kwanza itakayo kuja,
what have I done?
Ni nini nilichokifanya?
To deserve this.
Kustahili haya.
Kweli ama hapana?
Kweli.
If you go to hospital,
ukienda hospitali,
they discover you are sick,
na watambua ugonjwa,
your first question,
swali la kwanza,
what did I do?
Je, ni nini nilichokifanya?
To deserve this.
Kustahili haya.
The devil wants you to understand,
Shetani anataka uelewe,
that what you are going through,
ya kuwa unayapitia,
is punishment.
Ni
is a punishment.
Ni adhabu.
It is a result of a sin committed. That's why you are going through that. So once you understand that it is, let's say it is God revenging on you. It is God punishing you because of what you did. Automatically you become powerless. You are not strong anymore.
Hauna nguvu tena.
You lose your confidence.
Unapoteza ujasiri.
Because you understand,
kwa maana unaelewa,
that your relationship with God has been cut off.
Umekatizwa.
You are on your own.
Wewe uko peke yako.
So you give up.
Kwa hiyo unakata
you lose hope.
Unapoteza.
Your faith in God,
imani ndani,
is now destroyed.
Inaangamizwa.
Out of guilt.
Kupitia hali ya hatia.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's why
Diposa,
Adam and Eve,
Adamu na Hawa,
ran away.
Walitoroka.
Guilt. We don't deserve God anymore. We have sinned against him. We cannot see his face. Let us run away. They went into running. The devil wants you to run. He wants me to run. Until where? Where can we run to? Where can we hide before the face of the Almighty God? Where can you hide? You cannot hide anywhere. So this is the gospel that we are proclaiming here. And this gospel, the devil doesn't want it proclaimed. The devil wants legalism. Can you put 14? Colossians 2:14. Look at that word, legal demands. Legal demands, that is what the people in the Old Testament did. Legality. We have caught this woman in the house of adultery. The law, the legal requirements tell us to stone her. She must die. Legalism. Hallelujah. They thought they can live by the law. They can please God by the law. They can enter heaven by the law. Do you understand? But the law is not given for people to enter heaven. The law is given to reveal God. How holy God is. How powerful God is. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The devil came to Jesus.
Shetani akamjia Yesu.
Turn stones into bread.
Akamwambia pendua mawe yawe mkate.
You have that power.
Maana unayo nguvu ile.
Even though he had that power.
Ingawa anayo nguvu ile.
The problem was to obey the devil.
Shida ilikuwa ni kumtii Shetani.
Why should I obey you?
Mbona nikutii wewe?
Why should I turn stones into bread at your order, at your command?
Mbona nigeuze mawe kuwa mkate kupitia sheria yako?
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
Man shall not live by bread alone.
Mwanadamu hataishi kwa
mkate pekee. By the word of God.
Lakini kwa neno la.
And then he comes again.
Kisha aja tena.
Throw yourself down.
Jirushe toka tu.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because I know.
Kwa maana najua.
It is written.
Imeandikwa.
So the devil knows the word.
Shetani anajua maandiko.
He knows the scripture.
Anajua maandiko.
It is written.
Imeandikwa.
God will send his angels.
Atatuma malaika wake.
They will carry you.
Na watakubeba.
You are not going to stumble.
Hautajikwaza.
Throw yourself down.
Sasa jirushe chini.
Jesus says.
Yesu anasema.
It is written.
Imeandikwa.
You shall not tempt.
Usimjaribu.
Yahweh God.
Mungu Bwana.
Your God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You see, so that's how he plays.
Hivyo ndivyo anacheza.
He wants you to feel guilt.
Anataka
uhisi hatia. Once you feel guilt,
unapohisi hatia,
you are a prey.
Wewe umekuwa.
People will come to church.
Watu watakuja kanisani.
They are not happy.
Hawana furaha.
These people are locked up.
Watu hawa
they are in prisons.
Wako katika jela.
They are in chains.
Wako minyororoni.
Even when telling to laugh,
hata ukimwambia acheke,
they have difficulties to laugh.
Ana ugumu wa kucheka.
They have a problem to laugh.
Wako na shida ya kucheka.
As I'm preaching now,
ninapohubiri sasa,
just look at yourself.
Anakuangalia.
You have a problem to laugh.
Uko na shida ya kucheka.
Laughter is a stranger to you.
Nikicheka ni kigeni kwako.
Laughter is a foreigner to you.
Ni kigeni kwako.
Because you cannot laugh.
Kwa maana hauwezi cheka.
Because you are in prison.
Kwa maana uko jela.
You are a captive.
Wewe ni mfungwa.
Yeah, put you somewhere there. You feel guilty. You have done stuff. You don't know where to take them to. And you are just there. God, this is what I did. Where shall I go? And the devil is there to tell you, you are finished. You are finished. Wait for a punishment. There is nothing you can do about it. You are finished. So we are here to tell you that this Jesus, he cancelled.
Alifuta.
He cancelled.
Alifuta.
All the legal requirements.
Hali zote za kisheria.
All the legal demands.
Mahitaji yote ya kisheria.
That stood against you.
Ambayo alisimama dhidi yako.
He cancelled them.
Akafutilia.
Put them out of your way.
Kando,
and then.
Na kisha,
he didn't stop there.
Akusimama pale.
He went now.
Akaenda.
And took those legal requirements.
Anakaenda kachukua zile mahitaji ya kisheria.
And did them like this.
Naye akayakunja kunja.
He said,
akasema,
legal demand.
Nyinyi mahitaji
ya kisheria. I cancel you.
Ninawafutilia.
And then,
na kisha,
legal demand.
Mahitaji ya kisheria.
I kneel you.
Ninakutundika.
At the cross.
Pale msalabani.
The Bible says,
Biblia yasema,
nailing it at what?
Akayatundika wapi?
At the cross.
Msalabani.
So after kneeling the legal demand at the cross,
baada ya kuyatundika msalabani,
it means
yamaanisha,
they cannot stand against you anymore.
Wasisimama dhidi yako tena.
This is what the devil doesn't want to hear.
Ndio shetani hataki kusikia.
And this is the gospel that you have been given.
Na ndio injili ambayo umepewa.
And then what is happening?
Na kisha matukio ni
now disarms.
Sasa akamnyang'anya silaha.
The enemy.
Adui.
The rulers.
Watawala,
the authorities. And put them to shame.
Na akawatia aibu.
Because before that,
kwa maana kabla ya yale,
the devil stood against you,
shetani alisimama
condemning you.
Akikuhukumu,
he said, you shall not go far.
Akisema hautaenda mbali.
You shall not see good.
Hautaona mema.
You shall not prosper.
Hautaendelea.
That was his words.
Hiyo ilikuwa neno
lake. Against your life.
Dhidi ya maisha yako.
But now,
lakini sasa,
because of Jesus,
kwa ajili ya Yesu,
you shall prosper.
Utafanikiwa.
Because of Jesus,
kwa ajili ya Yesu,
you move forward.
Wewe utaenenda.
Because of Jesus,
kwa ajili ya Yesu,
you can smile.
Unaweza tabasamu.
Now,
sasa,
because he said,
kwa sababu alisema,
you shall not prosper,
hautana,
now,
sasa,
he is ashamed,
yeye anaona haya,
because God is blessing you.
Mungu anakubariki.
He is ashamed,
anaona haya,
because God is prospering you.
Mungu anakufanya
unyenyekevu. He is ashamed,
yeye anaona aibu,
because you shall enter heaven.
Kwa maana utaingia mbinguni.
He is ashamed,
yeye anaona aibu,
because Jesus,
kwa maana Yesu,
knelt all his accusations.
Alitunduka yote msalabani.
Those accusations,
yale shtuma zote,
they are the ones that gave him power.
Ndizo zilizompa nguvu.
They gave him authority.
Ikampa mamlaka.
To accuse you.
Ya kukushtaki.
To dominate you.
Ya kukutawala.
Now, those accusations,
sasa shtuma zote,
he took them.
Akayachukua.
Nailed them at the cross.
Akayatundika msalabani.
Now the devil,
sasa shetani,
is empty-handed.
Ako mikono mitupu.
He has no document.
Hana lolote.
To accuse you.
Ya kukushtaki.
Oh my God. Because
kwa sababu,
whatever that was written
chochote kilicho andikwa,
has been nailed at the cross.
Kimetundikwa msalabani.
Now it's empty-handed.
Sasa haiwezi.
His power,
nguvu zake,
is in condemnation.
Iko katika hukumu.
His power,
nguvu yake,
is in making you feel guilty.
Ikufanya uhisi hatia.
His power,
nguvu yake,
is you feeling that you have been separated from God.
Umetengwa na Mungu.
That's what gives him power.
Ndio inachompa nguvu.
Now that he doesn't have,
sasa yakuwa hana nguvu,
any argument against you,
hana lolote dhidi yako,
the carnet, unajua carnet, kitabu cha shetani,
kitabu cha shetani
ya kuandika mambo
kile anacho na kile mambo
kinyume na wewe, bali mnyanganya naye bana, ipiga kwa msalaba.
Amen.
Sio njo silaha yake.
Yes,
that's what Jesus says.
Ndipose Yesu akasema,
he has been disarmed.
Amenyanganywa silaha.
Hana nguvu tena.
Amen.
Hana nguvu tena.
Amen.
Silaha yake wamechukua.
Hallelujah.
Silaha wamefanya nini?
Wamechukua.
Hapana kuchukua, sema wamepokonya.
Wamepokonya yeye.
Silaha yake wamefanya nini?
Wamemnyang'anya.
Simama kwa miguu yako. Silaha yake wamefanya nini?
Wamemnyang'anya.
Wamepokonya.
Amen.
Wamepokonya.
Amen.
Now, when you have this understanding, you walk in freedom. Why should we go to church? Come out with burdens. Why should we go to church? Come out frustrated. Why should we go to church? Come out condemned. No. We are not here to enjoy church. We are here to celebrate Jesus. We come to celebrate. He's a God of celebration, not God of endurance. He says, bring your luggages, bring your burdens, bring. Let me carry for you. Lift up your hands. In your mother tongue, I want you to speak to God. Say, my enemy has been disarmed in the name of Jesus. Every weapon he had fabricated against my life has been nullified. He has no power over my life. I'm a child of God. I'm blessed. God is my portion. God is my portion. God is my portion. God is my portion. I shall live to move forward. I shall live to see prosperity. I shall live to enjoy the blessings of my creator. Can you speak to God? Can you speak to God? Can I hear you speak? Can I hear you speak? Can you glorify him? Can you worship him? Can you make declaration that from today I shall live long? That from today I shall live long? That from today blessing shall be my portion? That from today peace shall be my portion? That from today joy shall be my portion? Because all my condemnations have been dealt at the cross. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. We glorify you in the name of Jesus. We bless you, God of the Bible, wonderful God. What is the gospel? Is that Jesus died? What is the gospel? Jesus paid the price. What is the gospel? We are free. What is the gospel? No condemnation. What is the gospel? The devil has been ashamed. Father, we thank you. Father, we bless you. Father, we glorify you. Receive glory. Receive honor. Today and forever. We are here to celebrate the work of the cross. We are here to celebrate the work of the cross. We are here to celebrate the work of the cross. Thank you, Lord. We bless you. In Jesus' name. Can we say amen? Wow.